Asshole.
I don't think you're taking this seriously, man. The whole meditation is for you not to get pissed off.
Well, you're pissing me off because you're over here trying to show off that you know more than me and shit.
I'm just trying to correct you, man.
Fuck you. Try to correct me. You fucking learn how to talk like the rest of us, you son of a bitch. We have fancy words and shit. Trying to be white in the white city and shit.
Shut up.
You think you're all cool because you're over there in New Jersey and shit? Fuck you.
All right.
We're moving on.
Let's
Something fucking amazing happened this week.
What happened?
We got 10 new subscribers. Oh, yeah. We made it to 350 subs. That's 10 in 1 week. That's the most we've ever gotten since we started this stupid channel.
Don't call it stupid.
Hey, fuck you. I didn't realize, but Gomer's been sending me messages on Twitter. I didn't even check them. I just saw him realize the other day. I was like, holy shit. He sent us some pictures and shit. The first picture he sent right here. It's me as John Wayne. Oh, yeah. He says, Courage is being scared to death and then settling up anyways. Oh, yeah. That's badass. Like, I'm a bandana in there. I would wear my bandana over my hat like that. Hey, and then he sent another one, and it's me and you. And I think, what movie was this in? Something Jack or some shit like that. Jack Boy, I don't remember what movie this was, but I seen this one. You're the Mexican kicker.
I can see that.
Hey, he said one more kicker. All right, he said me, John Wayne, and all riding on Dumbo and flying away from these racist crows, and you're the crows, and Elon Musk is one of the crows, and that's how it says, fly faster, you get us away from them. Oh, yeah. Cheers, Gomer.
Fucking Gomer. Cheers, man. I'm sorry, I don't have one of your beers, but it'll come right now.
What
don't worry about
it. What the fuck are you
drinking? Shit to get me fucked up, you know?
You're fucking blue red. Yeah. Fuck yeah. All right.
Hey. No Bud Light.
For those 10 of you motherfuckers who just showed up, let me tell you right now, hopefully you don't unsubscribe. And we're drunk and fucked up and we're high, we're getting high, and this is all we do and shit. We talk shit about everything that happened during the week with all your nerd fucking news. And if there's spoilers, we go over to spoilers and shit. All right? We try not to put clickbaits or bullshit. We try to give you the shit that's real. When we hit 500 subscribers, those of you who comment and talk shit and make us laugh on the comments are eligible to win these woke as fuck shirts. We're gonna give 5 away when we hit 500 subscribers. So make sure you comment and you like the videos, motherfuckers. 2,000 fucking views, and only like 7 of you liked it and shit. But anyways, man, I'm just saying. We're gonna give these away. We already give 3 away for the 300. When we hit 500, we're gonna give a 5 away and shit on Kika's dime. All right, let's get started with the motherfucking comments, Kike. And we're going to start with a new motherfucker. Let's give him the DJ horn, Kike, because he's new.
Go ahead and do it.
Oh, yeah, 3, 2, 1.
There you go.
All right. He has, he's talking on the tour, Love and Thunder spoilers. The only time we ever get motherfuckers showing up is whenever we give away the fucking movies and shit. Usually, it's true. He's a fucking lazy motherfucker. But we try to put we get the spoilers and spoil an entire movie at least a month in advance. Unfortunately, Kevin Feige's getting smarter, and now we're getting the spoilers like a week before because they're not, these motherfucking pussies that go to the screenings, they sign a piece of paper that said they're gonna get sued, but they're dumbasses because they can go under a VPN, hide their master IP address, change their names on Reddit, and still spoil the movie. But these motherfuckers are a bunch of pussies, and we're not getting spoilers like we used to, Kike.
Nope.
We're not. So this is the best we could do. Anyways, he says, no. The movie starts with the story being told, and it'll be the tone in the past tense. So he dies, and we'll see by the end of the film, Thor will have died, and it'll be Jane, the mighty Thor, who's died, and Thor, oldest son, will be off to new adventures and renewed sense of being with Gore's fucking daughter. And if you would have watched the rest of the video instead of clicking away after fucking 5 minutes, you would have known we said all that shit.
Right, man. Chill, bro.
Oh, yeah. Hang on. Let me practice it.
All right, better?
Yeah, I'm good. Hey, I see, Dragon. That's all right, motherfucker. That's all right. You know, I know you're probably one of these motherfuckers. You know, that's cool. But we said it already in the video and shit. And yeah, fine. So maybe it doesn't start with the way Gore tells a story, but it starts with fucking, and we, and that's still in the video. And we said right there that motherfucking was that rock creature, Crow Korg. And he's telling the story to the kids and shit of everything that went down. We said that from the beginning. So it's all in there, motherfucker. But either way, I don't know if you're one of these 10 motherfuckers who just subscribe, but this is the kind of channel this is. So get ready to talk shit any chance you get. And if this motherfucker down here says anything racist, you better fucking timestamp it and let everyone know how much of a racist he's being and shit. But either way, cheers, AIC Dragon, you pussy.
Cheers. Hey, man, you're going to make it out subscribe, man. Why you got to be so belligerent?
Well, hey, that's the way we talk, all right? Hey, this guy's cool. AIC Dragon's cool. He knows what's up. He knows what's up. Well, click on it. Skip there. All right. Yeah, for all you who don't know, we drinking, we smoking shit. So we're high as fuck. I don't even know what I'm doing half the time.
I can.
We got another new motherfucker, Dan Kitos Prime. And he says, my pause button reaction skill is master class. He put a laughing emoji. I don't know what that means, Kike.
I don't even know what that means either. Because I don't even have the comments here. So I'm relying on you to read them.
He's over there in the rich white city, but he didn't need a vacation, but he didn't even have the correct internet and shit. Fuck you, Kike.
Well, I don't want to log all my fucking passwords in a laptop that I don't own.
Kike, so. It's Google. Saves and syncs everything. As long as you log into a different computer, everything's there.
I know.
Including your porn history. Cheers! Dan Kitos. Cheers,
you would know.
Dan Kitos Prime. You're goddamn right, I know, motherfucker. You'll be coming at me, Kike. I'll fuck you up.
Oh, talking about passwords, because I just updated my password here. I know.
A new one. I don't know if this is a new subscriber, but we're going to give this motherfucker the DJ horn. 3, 2, 1, Kike. yeah. Emma Okioi, she might be one of these foreigners from Japanese or something. Says, how powerful is OG Thor in this movie compared to previous ones? He's strong as fuck. I mean, you see it when he's working out. You see when he's working out those chains and he's pulling the fucking shit.
He's been the buffest on this one.
He's been the strongest one up until Captain Marvel, lesbian showed up. But before that, he's always been the strongest Avenger. And that's the running gag is that he says he's stronger than Hulk and shit. Cheers, Emma Okio. Okio? Okio? Mm-hmm. Okio? I think that's how you say it.
Make fun of their last name, man.
I don't know. I'm trying to pronounce it the right way, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Cheers!
Cheers.
Hey, Kike, I'm getting the echo from your headset, from your headphones to the mic. You have your audio too loud.
Sorry.
You know damn right I scream, so you better lower it. Yes.
I know. All right.
Ari Shuv. Hey, Kike, we're getting nothing but foreigners. Hey.
That's good.
It's fine. I don't have any problem
with
that.
Diversity.
All right. Yeah. I like my brown skis all over the world. What the fuck is that noise, Kike?
The dogs.
It sounds like a thunderstorm.
Yeah, well, there is a thunderstorm coming. They're probably bitching about that.
Well, I'm bitching about the noise. You ass. You're fucking up my transcendence. I just meditated all day for this shit.
It's fucking up your chi, your chakras.
Yeah.
All right. Eat it up, man.
Ari, shuv, shuvi, shuv, shuv.
He says, Oh, that sounded like fucking Ari, you.
No, fuck you. He says, like for real, it doesn't need to sound any good. He's talking about Thor, Love and Thunder. Or even any goodish. Yeah. Number one, because Jane is sick, does it make her worthy of the hammer? In the hammer, can piece itself together? Why isn't Thor worthy then? Guess what, Adi?
They don't give an explanation at all.
They don't give an explanation as far as from all the stuff I've read online from all fuckers who got to go see it, those pussies. They don't give an explanation. She just touches the hammer or it comes together and she's the Thor.
Well, you would think that maybe because she has cancer, she humbles herself a little bit because of the sickness. Right, and now
she's smarter than the rest of us, so he's got an explanation and it makes a lot of sense. Fuck you, Kiki, for being right, you ass.
I'm just saying, bro.
Go ahead, explain it because it sounds right. It sounds right.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm thinking. I mean, like, once you have a terminal illness, like, then, you know, you humble yourself. You're a little bit more of a better person.
Fuck. I'm fucking arresting y'all to death, motherfuckers.
Well, we all know that. But in this case, in the movie, she does. So I guess that's my theory. I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the case.
Well, you know, like the rest of us, they're going to fuck us over because they're not going to give us an explanation, Adi. At least that's what people are saying online. I didn't hear the whole podcast, but God in the comics, Gore in the comic books decided to kill gods because humans are sacrificing their lives to serve them. But in exchange, they're receiving nothing, which is reasonable. So Jane's death, whatever you count her as a human or a god, wouldn't prove anything else. And I'm not a big fan of mediocre jokes. Oh, yeah, dude. That's what I'm most afraid about this movie is they're saying it's joke after joke after joke after joke after joke after joke. And I liked Thor Ragnarok, Guardians of the Galaxy 2. And this is two different directors. But Guardians of the Galaxy 2 was excessive jokes. One after the other, after the other, after the other, after the other, scene to scene to scene. And it's sad because Guardians of the Galaxy 1 was funny, but it didn't do that through the whole film. It wasn't excessive, but part 2 was super excessive jokes, like nonstop. And they're saying that this is what this movie is like, that it's nonstop jokes. And that's what worries me because, like I said, man, like I like jokes in there and I like Thor Ragnarok, but if it's going to be joke after joke after joke after joke and never resting, it's going to piss me off, bro.
Well, I still have faith on this director. I mean, yeah, he is essentially a comedian that turned into a director, and he's a writer and whatnot. But at the end of the day, whatever he puts out as a production, part of his production, or, you know, he's the one author of the production, whatever the fuck you want to call it, it's always been successful. It's always been good. Yeah, I know that he does a lot of movies that has a lot of jokes in it, but let's hope that there's more like background and the hit on the story. We already know that fucking Gore the Butcher sucks in this one because he's not really an alien. He looks like a human being.
But not only that, but his story is nothing like it. He is not Gore the God Butcher. It's a completely different character, and he's a pussy because at the end he decides to sacrifice himself because he feels bad after he sees Jane Thor die. Fuck you, Kike, and your dogs. He sees Thor, Jane die, and he's a pussy. And he feels sorry like a little pussy. And he decides to sacrifice himself, not kill any gods, and then bring back his daughter, which makes no fucking sense. And then Thor, all of a sudden, just meets his daughter and says, let's go on adventures together. And the movie ends with them going in space and adventures. It makes no fucking sense at all, Kike.
Well, I know. I mean, we already covered that, so. Yep.
Yeah. Adi, this movie sucks ass. It'll probably be visually good looking. It'll probably be at least 70% entertaining. But all the 30% that we know should have been good from comic book lore is shitted on. And I don't know why. Yeah. And I don't know why. Because now with all the interviews we're seeing and all the bullshit, I was mad about Christian. You were saying Christian Bale didn't want to wear prosthetics, Kike. Well, guess what, Kike? He did wear prosthetics. He never shaved his head.
Really?
Yeah. Everything, his whole, except for this part, but everything else was prosthetics on him. And he did sit in a chair. He did sit in a chair for hours.
Yeah.
And got painted on and put plastic on and all that shit. So
I don't understand why they couldn't have made him look like Gore then.
They could have done the same thing they did to Hulk and just put little fucking dots on his thing and then just fucking do CGI on him. But it would have been a lot easier for him, you know, that way he doesn't have to go through fucking makeup.
And I know there's interviews saying that, Gore in the comic books, he's wearing a thong and he's naked and he's ripped and I couldn't have done that. Look, I understand that, Christian Bale, and I would have been okay with them putting a robe on you like Mother Teresa. The biggest problem with me is the fact that you physically in your face, in your head, don't look like Gore. And then the worst part is that nothing of the story or origin or finale or anything, arc of Gore in the MCU, nothing of it is like the comic books. Yep. That's the biggest problem.
Yep.
To me. But anyways, let's move on.
Once I see it, we'll see.
This is just pissing me off, and unfortunately, I'm going to go see it because my girlfriend just saw another trailer, and she's like, this movie's going to be wonderful and shit, and I'm all like, God damn it. Oh, all right, I guess I'll have to buy the tickets and shit.
God dang it, Bobby.
Yeah. Damn, the things we do for pussy geeking. Anyways, let's move on. All right, cheers, Adi.
Hey, cheers, bro. Thanks for commenting.
Oh, Mike Hill. On Thor spoilers, of course.
Talking about King of the Hill.
He says, "Is there Hercules in this?" Yeah. And I told him, "Skip to the end of the video, motherfucker. We go over the end of credit scenes." Look, I don't know why motherfuckers don't like. There are a lot of pussies out there that don't drink and smoke. You can't.
Yeah.
Because I could tell you, man, I think everybody here in my neighborhood, especially in my complex, everywhere, everyone's fucked up, man. I drive around, it's fucking 8 in the morning, and there's motherfuckers going to the store to buy beer, and they're walking out with beer and shit.
Yeah.
I mean, come on now. This is America. We drink and we smoke. Hey, baby. Yeah, so I don't know why y'all don't want to fucking watch a video and find out everything we say, because we only stick the facts in this video, right, Kiki?
I mean, Sun states it's facts. Yeah, I guess.
It is facts, motherfucker. Just because I don't talk like you, fuck you.
Right?
Use your big words. Hey, Mike Hill, cheers.
Mikey. Cheers, bro.
Cancel for life. For life. He says, yo, dudes, a friend of mine's is claiming he's seen it. And I told him what you said in the video. And he said you pretty much have it down to a T. You're missing some stuff, but it's a basic outline. Great job, whoa dudes. Aw, yeah. I figured, I mean, everybody's confirming now. Basically, everything we said is what happened. There's a lot of details missing because a lot of these motherfuckers are still being pussies, like his friend who went to go see it. You probably had to sign one of those papers and shit. We'll cut off your balls if you say anything and shit. But yeah. I don't give a fuck. I'll say it, motherfucker. I don't even want my balls. They're in the way all the time and shit. And I want to get...
They're getting longer as we speak.
And and I don't want to get bitches pregnant. So yeah. Cut them off, Mickey Mouse. I don't give a fuck. I'll still tell the internet. Cheers, canceled.
Cheers, canceled.
We got a new one, Kika. Let's give this an old motherfucker to DJ Horn. 3, 2, 1. This guy is a white motherfucker. His name's Keaton Alley.
I don't know why you have to say it like that, but okay.
Yeah, well, I gotta represent, you know, we gotta represent all cultures, Kika. We're not just representing browns, we're representing Americans, and Americans is full of just browns, whites, yellows, blacks, purples, greens, and blues and shit. They're all over the place.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So Keaton Allen is one of the motherfuckers over here, but he says, damn, bro, I haven't seen the movie yet, but just bitching about things you don't even know will play out like that. Well, fucking, how are you? I don't want to repeat myself, Keaton Allen. You go rewind the video back. We just said it to the other motherfucker, all the things why we hate it, because it's basically ruining the adaptation of one of the greatest comic book villains that Thor, the God of Thunder, ever had. And it's not even that nothing. The only thing that is Gore the God Butcher in the MCU from the Gore the God Butcher's the comic book is the name. That's it. Yeah. The sword is just a sword. It does not even the symbiote and nothing. It's just, it's shitty. It's shitty, and it is gonna suck. And unfortunately, I'm gonna have to go watch it and shit. It won't want to keep getting late.
Yeah.
You know. That's why it is, motherfucker. Yeah. I know what it is, all right? There's nothing wrong with saying the movie sucks if it sucks, all right?
Yeah.
I'm sure it's going to make $1 billion and all you motherfuckers are going to love it and there's going to be another one and I'm fine with that. I accept it.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying, and yes, I'll even say it's probably going to be one of the better MCU movies that we're going to be seeing. In fact, better ones that we've been seeing because unfortunately the only fucking badass Marvel movie we've seen is since Phase 4 started has been Spider-Man. And unfortunately, that has had Amy Pascal's fucking pussy all over it and that scares me.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
But anyways, we have been talking too much about Thor.
Yeah, we're moving on. The cheers, Keaton Allen. Moving on.
Hey, cheers, bro. Thanks for commenting.
Yeah. Oh, Kike, no, ma'am. Hey, Kike's out of town, so he doesn't have a little machine there. Fuck you, Kike. No, ma'am. You better tell him off next week for this shit, because he didn't have a clip for you and shit. But anyways, no, ma'am. No, ma'am's here. And he says, leave it to the wokest dudes on YouTube to spoil it again. I'm going to go see it next week. I bet you guys are right about it, just like Spider-Man. Oh, yeah. Kike, quit fucking up. Just kidding.
Well, I didn't fail this time. I did fuck up, so
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, there you go. No, man, you already knew he was going to fuck up. No, man's a prophet. Oh, yeah. Cheers, no, man.
Cheers, man.
Hey, Kike. What are those fucking pussy-ass dogs barking at?
They're battling. Like, soon you're just going to hear one, and that's going to be the guy, the one dog that defeats all the other ones.
Just,
so.
Why don't you go over there and just hit them both with a hammer, and then they both lose. And we win.
No, I can't do that. I'll let nature take care of it.
All right, fine. Rocco fucked my life, and he put sun direct quotes. Genius, man. He put a timestamp, Kike. I know you don't have your device there, so you can't click on it. And if I click on it, I'm going to fuck it up. So, Kike, I know you saw it. What does it say?
Well, I don't know. I'm on vacation. I don't have the clip.
Well, fuck you. It's the worst we've ever done, thanks to Kike, who's supposed to be in charge of the bullshit. And here, prepare. Look, if he knew he was going to go out of town.
Next week, I'll fucking make up for that one. It's only one audio clip. Come on.
Anyways, he says, damn foreigners, cheers, son. Who knows what the fuck I said?
There you go. That's exactly what you said.
What? I don't know what I said.
That's exactly what you said.
No, he's saying, damn foreigners, cheers, son.
Mm-hmm.
This movie sounds like total ass fest. I'm going to wait till it's on digital to download with my VPN instead. Oh, he put more. Let me see what he says. Thanks for the spoilers. Woke pack for life. Oh, yeah. Woke pack for life, motherfuckers. Cheers, Rocco, and fuck you, Kike, for making us look bad.
Hey, all right, fuck it.
It's no wonder Joe Rogan gets more views than us. Yes.
Oh, you're not gonna compare us to that fucking podcast, man. It's the biggest fucking podcast in the world. Shut up.
And a bald looking Boba Fett looking motherfucker. Anyways, Camilla-san 693, Kike. And the Gore the God Butcher is asking a bunch of fucking questions. Gore the God Butcher dies in the movie. Yes, he does. He sacrifices himself. Jeff Goldblum, the Grandmaster in the movie. No, he's not.
Yes.
Is Lady Sith in the movie?
Mm-hmm.
No, she's not. Cheers, Camilla-san. Something tells me you motherfucking didn't subscribe.
All right.
But we're still cheering to you because we like to drink.
Yeah. And thank you for commenting.
Again, Camilla-san, and this time he's got a different last name, Kronu-san. Yeah, we're getting all a bunch of these foreigners over here. He says, who dies, Korg or Meek? We don't know. There's no explanations, but I'm pretty sure that Korg does not die. Maybe Meek, because he's a piece of shit and looks ugly as fuck, so I would squash him if I saw him in real life anyway. Is Bastet killed
by Gore? They're going to kill him again.
Yeah. Is Bastet killed by Gore? No, she's not. Is it Tiri in the movie? No, he's not. And we'll talk about it later in the video. You can skip to that part. What happened to Asgardian actors? They all die. Gore kills them all. Yeah. All right, we're going to move on. Cheers, Camilla-san. You better fucking subscribe and like the videos.
Robert Iger. Oh, we're gonna give this Asian motherfucker the DJ horn. Yeah, 3, 2, 1. This guy's one of our yellowest fans out there, and I love this motherfucker to death. I gotta tell you, man, one of these days he's gonna get a shirt. He says, and maybe his wife too. Aw, yeah, hola. All right. He says, how has this, he's talking about Ezra Miller, Kike. How has this kid not been canceled yet? I'm glad he's not going to be the Flash anymore. Let's hope they don't hire someone worse. Cheers, dudes. Yeah, yeah, fuck this guy. And fuck all his crew and his fucking just craziness, you know, his craziness. He needs to grow the fuck up. He's almost 30 years old and shit. Cheers, Robo.
Cheers, Robo.
Jenny Clark on the Ezra Miller radio. None of this is new. You guys are higher than Ezra ever was. Yes, we are. But we're not rich and famous, and we're not fucking parading around with little kids putting guns and teddy bears and shit in our house. And our thing, you dumb, stupid bitch. Don't you understand that we do... Hey, shut the fuck up, Kike. We do this podcast at the end of the fucking week, so we're talking about all the week's news. And if you saw this on an expert video, then that's been another week since that shit came out, you dumbass. Cheers, Jenny Clark. We're still cheering to you, you fucking Karen.
In a very spiteful way, by the way. Well, you know, if it makes it any better, like there is a date on the upload when you see on YouTube. So
no,
you
can tell this is an expert video, and it's an expert from the weeks before podcast.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
And I don't explain it. She's a dumbass. She doesn't watch our channel. She doesn't subscribe or like. She's one of these Ezra Miller fucking fans, probably defending him on Twitter and shit.
Well, that's more of a possibility, actually.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So fuck you, Jenny Clark, and fuck Ezra Miller. We're moving on. We already cheered to you.
Yeah, thanks for commenting.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, Adi Shuv. Again. Hey, you know what? We're going to get this to DJ. We're going to get this motherfucker to DJ horn because he commented twice.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
3, 2, 1. Oh, yeah. Not for sure. I know he's a brownski like us. Oh, shoot. He might not be one of them. He not be a Mexican and shit because of his new name, Adi Chuv. He might not be a Mexican, but he one of motherfuckers from the other side, from the east. He get from the east. Oh, yeah. Oh, my brother's from another fucking mother and shit. Same father, Abraham. Oh, yeah. But anyways, he's commenting on the Ezra Miller video, and he says, the best podcast ever. Hey, Adi, you're the shit, motherfucker. You let us know what nationality you are, and if you're American or where the fuck you are, we're going to give you a shout-out, you motherfucker. Oh, yeah. Yep. Cheers, Adi.
Cheers, bro.
Hey, you become a regular commenter. You might win a shirt when we hit 500. Keep it up, Adi. Keep it up, motherfucker.
Yep.
All right. Oh, Indie Phantoms. Give the guy the DJ horn. You can. 3, 2, 1. Yeah! Indie Phantom is one of the winners on the 300. When we hit 300 subscribers, he got a shirt already. Woke us full. On the Kraven the Hunter video, he says, I barely remember Kraven the Hunter except that he showed up in some Marvel team ups when I was a kid. Who's his girlfriend going to be? AOC. Calypso. Nah, dude, it's gonna be this hot black lady. I just don't remember her name and shit. Doesn't he wear fur and crap? Yeah, yeah. He's probably gonna work for PETA, and definitely he'll be a vegan and woke. Yeah, that's what I was saying. Nice. I noticed you guys jumped to 347. We jumped to 350, motherfucker. You got a new subscriber every day. That's mostly thanks to the Pia Zadora, I think. You got us a strike, motherfucker. He's the one that got his copyright strike last time. Cheers, Indie Phantom, you motherfucker. You're the shit. Cheers, bro. Woke pack for life. Oh, yeah. This guy's a shit, bro. I love that guy.
Hey, by the way, Indie, thanks for the info. I got those shows.
Kike over here getting downloading shit from Canada. You know?
I can't get it in the US, man. You can't fucking find it. Like, it's almost like they've been canceled or some shit, man.
Well, I mean, you know, the United States of America, they don't like Canadians, but I'm one of the few that accepts people like all over the world and shit, you know.
Me too. It's fucking stupid. We're like the freest fucking country, but we cancel other people out. What the fuck is that about?
Yeah, I accept everyone for any of their racism, all right? You wanna hit them, that's fine with me. It's your every right, you know.
I didn't say that, by the way, but okay.
As long as
you treat everyone the same way, I'm okay with it.
Hey, Dolly B. I like that. Hey, Kiki, I tell you, these motherfuckers are all Browskis from the East. I mentioned.
That's good.
Hey, look, get your motherfucker to DJ Horn. 3, 2, 1. Aw, yeah. Hey, he says, the Thor Love and Thunder. He says, it sounds lame. Cool to see. But lame overall. That's what I said. Visually, it's gonna be a fun movie. You really have a laugh and shit. But when you come down to it, comic book wise nerd to the core, it sucks ass.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see.
Donnie B, I hope you subscribed and shit. Keep it up, motherfucker. You might win a shirt when we hit 500.
Yeah.
Oh, Kike, the trumpets will sound.
Let's see what it 2024.
Oh, yeah. Make America great again. This time it's true. Motherfucker. Yeah. But he says, when the Ezra Miller comic book got banned, Kike. He says, this had me laughing. Son sees dicks everywhere. Laughing my ass off. Cheers, woke dudes. Hey, the dicks were all there. You saw them. I outlined them for you. They're all there, motherfucker. They're perverted as shit. All right, there's dicks all over that comic book. It's just like Disney and shit. Cheers, trumpets.
Right, hey, cheers. Which, by the way, if you guys just want to watch the clips of the most funniest things, just go to our other channel and it's just clips of us. You'll see a link. But yeah, all of that stuff, including that one, is in there. So
yeah.
Make sure you subscribe to that channel too.
Or on TikTok and shit. On Twitter.
Yeah, on TikTok. We're on TikTok. I think we're more active on TikTok than we are on IG, right?
No, I think the same shit gets uploaded everywhere. All right. So as long as you subscribe to one of them, it'll be there and shit. And in case you haven't seen it, I'm posting it right now so you can see all our social medias and shit, and you can subscribe to them. But either way, they're shorter videos. Shorter videos than the experts. They're like minute videos, and you can just see the funny
things. Yeah.
Let's move on. Gomer Kyle on the Commons video. He said, hey, I want to say happy 4th of July. Be safe and bum.
Yeah,
one.
America.
Yeah. America, motherfuckers. And be safe and burn one for me over the weekends. Motherfucker, I burn one every morning for you, Gomer Kyle. I wake up in the morning, I roll a joint, and I'm like, this is for you, Gomer, you Tennessee motherfucker. Oh, yeah, you fucking Tennessee motherfucker. Yeah. So I talk about go orange and shit. Cheers.
Cheers, bro. Again, I'm sorry. I'll start drinking real beer in a bit. It's still Bud Light, though. I'm just saying.
Fuck you and your Bud Light. We only drink Miller. Pussy.
I don't care. Still American, bro.
Yeah, but Miller has the taste, Kike, and the quality. All right.
All right.
Oh, and just so you know, Bud is not American. It's German owned now.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's why I only drink Miller. I just represent America, motherfucker. It's German owned. They bought it. The Germans bought it.
Well,
it may be brewed here, but it's still fucking owned by Germans. Fucking Nazi. Well, Kike, no wonder you like that shit. Well,
now I'm just going to say to the owners, Doncashire.
Yeah, you fucking Nazi. You racist. We're moving on.
I just said thanks, man. I just said thanks.
Felix Poventude 3. Poventude. Let's give him the DJ horn to this fucking foreigner. 3, 2, 1. He says, what the fuck is wrong with you two? Let me see. We've been drinking for hours. We've been smoking weed We've done drugs, ecstasy, pills, all cocaine through our 20s and shit. I don't have an education. I was not educated properly. And this dumb
motherfucker. I did once.
Yeah, he did. I was there. I brought him back to life. Me and some other guy. And then this guy only has a 2-year degree. So, yeah, that's what the fuck is wrong with us, motherfucker. Let me ask you, Felix Bontevut, what the fuck is wrong with you? You live in the bomb, your mom's basement, not paying any fucking rent, huh? Cheers, you pussy.
Hey, cheers, bro. Thanks for commenting.
Right. Oh, shit. Oh, one more, the last one. The comment on a very old video. Hey, we're gonna get this guy DJ Orange just because I really okay. like his name. It's Rainmaker. 3, 2.
All right.
Ah, yeah.
All right, Rainmaker. Talking about my people here.
Yeah. Or wrestling, man. Okada. He says, America Chavez sucks. A super old fucking video of ours. He says the movie was terrible. Yes, it was.
Yeah, it was.
It finally came out on digital. Now, I had to go see it because my girlfriend's a big fan of Wanda. So I had to go see it and shit. So we went to go see it. But I didn't like it. It was underwhelming, is to say the least. I expected more out of a movie with a title that says Multiverse of Madness. And there was no multiverses. And there was no madness.
There was no madness, man.
No. It was ass. But we've already explained it on all the other videos, review of the movies, and just tearing it apart and shit. But basically, I downloaded this movie digitally, and I haven't rewatched it at all. I just have it there.
That's funny because I did the same thing. Yeah. I have fucking Disney, but I haven't seen it again.
Yeah. I just have it there for the bank, just to have it. And my friend, the other day, I talked to my friend. I was on a Fortnite. We were squatting and playing and shit. And he said, "Hey, yeah, I saw Multiverse of Madness again because it was finally on Disney Plus." And he says, "And I think I like it even less now." He says it was boring. He goes, "I was just like, man, this movie really—it was not as epic as it should have been."
It should have been a lot better.
It should have been better than Spider-Man No Way Home, and it wasn't.
Dude, it's just that the places they went and the dimensions that they went, it was just one or two or something. Places? And that was it.
That's what I said, places? No, they ain't got no places. They go to one fucking world, and that's it. Fuck
dude, that's
you.
So stupid.
And all the greatest characters they could ever assemble die within seconds, and the females. Oh, no, I don't want to get into this because I'm getting pissed off. You're ruining my breathing techniques. I just practiced afternoon and shit.
Yeah. Go reset your chakras, bro. Reset your chakras.
Rainmaker, cheers, motherfucker. Cheers, you're bro. The shit, and we represent. The movie did suck ass.
Hey, like shit like this, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel and check out the full podcast on the link to the right where we discuss more topics we don't post on these short videos. Peace.